Pomaže Bog, dragi moji veroučenici, dragi moji šestaci, dobrodošli na još jedan čas pravoslavne veronauke online. Pre početka našeg veronaučnog časa pomolit ćemo se našem Gospodu, našem Tvorcu, u ime Oca i Sina i Svetoga Duha. Care nebeski, utešitelju duše istine, koji si svuda i sve ispunjavaš, riznicu dobara i davaoča života, dođi i useli se u nas i očisti nas od svake nečistote i spasi blagi duše naše. Slava Ocu i Sinu i Svetome Duhu, sada i uvek i u vekove vekova. Amin. Za današnji čas ono što nam je potrebno jeste tablet, računar ili mobilni telefon, sveska i olovka. Međutim, pre početka našeg izlaganja moramo da se podsjetimo šta smo to radili prošli čas, pa smo govorili o tome kako se Gospod Isus Hristos popeo na goru i poučavao svoje apostole i okupljeni narod oko njega. I tom prilikom Hristos je izrekao blaženstva ili blažena, koja ćemo sada ponoviti. A kad on vide narod mnogi, pope se na goru i sede, i pristupiše mu učenici njegovi, i otvorivši usta svoja učaše i govoreći, blaženi siromašni duhom, jer je njihovo carstvo nebesko, blaženi koji plaču, jer će se utešiti, blaženi krotki, jer će naslediti zemlju, blaženi gladni i žedni pravde, jer će se nasititi, blaženi milostivi jer će biti pomilovani, blaženi čisti srcem jer će Boga vidjeti, blaženi mirotvorci jer će se sinovi Božiji nazvati, blaženi prognani pravde radi jer je njihovo carstvo nebesko. Blaženi ste kada vas sramote i progone i lažući govore protiv vas svakojake rđave reči zbog mene. Radujte se i veselite se jer je velika plata vaša na nebesima. Rekli smo da je Novi Zavet savršeniji od staroga u shvatanju ljubavi i prema Bogu i prema bližnjima. Oni koji vole Boga i ljude ispunjavaju Božje zapovesti i Božiju volju. Na današnjem veronaučnom času govorit ćemo o novozavetnoj zapovesti i besedi na gori. Dakle, nastavljamo sa onom temom sa kojom smo prošli put govorili, ali nismo završili, jer smo pričali samo o blaženima, kako je Gospod Isus Hristos poučavao svoj apostol i narod, ali Hristos i dalje ostaje na toj gori i poučava narod. A šta je dalje govorio, to ćete, draga moja deco, saznati na ovom današnjem času. Posle izbranja apostola, Isus Hristos je sišao sa njima sa vrha gore i zaustavio se na ravno mesto. Ovdje su ga čekali mnogobrojni njegovi učenici i veliko mnoštvo naroda koji se sabrao sa svih krajeva jevrejske zemlje i iz susjednih njoj zemalja. Oni su došli da saslušaju Hrista i da dobiju isceljenja od svojih bolesti. Svi su htjeli da se dotaknu Spasitelja, jer je od njega ishodila sila i isceljivala sve. Videvši pred sobom mnogo naroda, Isus Hristos, okružen učenicima, pošao je na uzvišenje na gori i seo da bi učio narod. Na početku Gospod je ukazao kakvi treba da budu njegovi učenici, to jest svi hrišćani. Kako su oni dužni da ispunjavaju zakon Boži? Da bi primili blažen, to jest u višem stepenu, radostan, srećan, večni život u carstvu nebeskom, i zbog toga im je Gospod dao 9 zapovesti blaženstava. Zatim je Gospod dao učenje o promislu Božjem, o neosuđivanju drugih, o sili molitve, o milostinji i o mnogom drugom. Ta propoved Isusa Hrista naziva se propoved na gori ili beseda na gori. Tako u čistom prolećnom danu, pri tihom duvanju svežine sa Galilejskog jezera, na strminama gore pokrivene zelenilom i cvećem, Spasitelj daje ljudima novozavetni zakon ljubavi. U Starom Zavetu Gospod je dao zakon u besplodnoj pustinji na gori Sinaji. Tada su strašni, tamni oblaci prekrili vrh gore. Grmeo je grom, sevale su munje i čuo se zvuk trube. Niko se nije smeo približiti gori osim proroka Mojsija, kom je Gospod predao 10 zapovesti zakona. A sada Gospod je okružen gustom gomilom naroda. Svi se trude da priđu bliže k njemu i dodirnu njega, makar i kraj njegove odeće, da bi primili od njega blagodatnu silu. I niko ne odlazi od njega bez utehe. Starozavetni zakon je zakon stroge pravde, a novozavetni zakon, Hristov zakon, je zakon božanstvene ljubavi i blagodati koji daje ljudima silu da ispune Božji zakon. Sam Isus Hristos je rekao, ja sam došao ne da ukinem zakon, nego da ispunim. Isus Hristos, Gospod i Spasitelj naš, kao Otac koji nas ljubi, ukazuje nam puteve ili dela kroz koja ljudi mogu ući u Carstvo nebesko, Carstvo Božije. Svima koji budu ispunjavali njegove pouke ili zapovesti, Hristos obećava kao car neba i zemlje večno blaženstvo, veliku radost, najvišu sreću u budućem večnom životu. Zato takve ljude on naziva blaženima, to jest najsrećnijima. Evo, u nastavku svoje besede na gori, Hristos je poučio svoje učenike i narod sljedećem. Pa sada ćemo pogledati video materijale gdje Hristos poučava sabrani narod i njegove učenike.
Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt has lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law, till all be fulfilled. Ye have heard that it hath been said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth.
What think ye?
He is guilty of death.
Death!
But I say unto you that ye resist not evil, but whosoever shall smite thee on thy right cheek, turn to him the other also. And if any man will sue thee at the law, and take away thy coat, let him have thy cloak also. And whosoever shall compel thee to go a mile, go with him twain. Give to him that asketh thee, and from him that would borrow of thee turn thou not away. Ye have heard that it hath been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thine enemy. But I say unto you, love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for them that despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. For if ye love them which love you, what reward have ye? Do not even the publicans the same? And if ye salute your brethren only, what do ye more than others? Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. Take heed that ye do not do your alms before men to be seen of them. Otherwise ye have no reward of your Father which is in heaven. Therefore when thou doest thine alms, do not sound a trumpet before thee, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may have glory of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet. And when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret. And thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. But when ye pray, use not vain repetitions as the heathen do, for they think that they shall be heard for their much speaking. Be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask him. After this manner, therefore pray ye. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. Judge not, that ye be not judged. For with what judgment ye judge, ye shall be judged. And with what measure ye mete shall be measured to you again. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye? Or how shalt thou say to thy brother, let me pull out the mote out of thine eye, and behold, a beam is in thine own eye? Thou hypocrite, first cast out the beam out of thine own eye, and then shalt thou see clearly to cast out the mote out of thy brother's eye. Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For every one that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Or what man is there of you, whom if his son ask bread, will he give him a stone? Or if he ask him a fish, will he give him a serpent? If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good gifts unto them that ask him? Therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them. For this is the law and the prophets. Enter ye in at the strait gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat, because strait is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life. And few there be that find it. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns, or figs of thistles? A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone who heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not shall be likened unto a foolish man which built his house upon the sand. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell. And great was the fall of it.
Dragi moji veroučenici, Nadam se da ste pogledali i ove video materijale koje smo imali u našoj prezentaciji, da ste shvatili kako je to Hristos govorio, poučavao narod. A nakon što smo se upoznali sa Hristovom besedom na gori, za vas ću imati jedan mali zadatak. Odgovorite na pitanja u svoju radnu svesku. Prvo pitanje glasi: šta znače reči da su hrišćani sol svetu? Zatim drugo pitanje: šta znače reči da su hrišćani svetlost svetu? I šta znači da ne smemo da se gnevimo na brata svoga? Kako treba da se ponašamo prema našim neprijateljima? To bi bilo sve, dragi moji veroučenici. Toliko za ovaj naš veronaučni čas. Do sljedećeg susreta. Živi, zdravi, srećni bili s Bogom.